Hello, my dear students. Welcome for today's video lecture of maths. Today we are going to start with our new chapter, chapter number 9, length. Okay. Since first standard, we have been learning about length. Length means what? We measure length of the various objects. Means what actually we do? We check or we measure how much that object is long. How much that object is long. That means what? See, suppose this is duster. This is what? Duster. So length of this duster means what? Distance between this point and this point. This distance between this point and this point. So this is the straight line and this is called the length of this duster. And how, what is length of this duster? It can be measured using various instruments like our ruler or measuring tape, measuring rod, etc. There are various objects or various things by which we can measure the length of any object. Understand? So length means what? The distance between starting point and ending point. Suppose this is considered as a starting point and this is its ending point. Then the length of this duster means the distance between starting and ending point. Understand this much? Okay. So in ancient time, when there were not standard things to measure the length, at that time our people were using the body parts to measure the length of the object. Like body parts means they were using the head span, foot span, or cubit. Cubit means distance from this middle finger to elbow. Okay, so they were using our body parts to measure the length of the object, like length of the far or length of our fall in this way. Okay, so now we have the standard units to measure the length. Why? Our ancient people, they were using our body parts to measure the length, but nowadays it is not used. Because why? Because see, body parts are different according to the different people. Like, right, my hand span is this much long. If the your hand span will be smaller than me, so if I measure the length of this blackboard using my hand span and you measure the length of this blackboard using your hand span, will it be same? Not at all, because my span is bigger or larger than your span. So the length according to my hand span, length will be smaller, and according to your hand span, length will be bigger. Okay, so that was not the reliable things or reliable way of measuring length. So nowadays we have standard units to measure the length. So we have standard instruments also, like ruler or measuring tape, etc. Okay, so nowadays when we measure length, we use units meter and centimeter. Meter and centimeter. Okay, and to measure longer distances, we use kilometer also. Like to measure distance between Khed to Mumbai, Khed to Chiklun, we use kilometer. Okay, so meter, centimeter. Centimeter is a unit to measure length of smaller object. Meter is standard unit of the length. Meter is the standard unit to measure the length. Okay, if the length is smaller, we use centimeter. If the length is greater or distance is greater, we use kilometer. Understand? So see here, open your textbook, page number 125. There is, do you remember? Let us check what is there in that. These things you have already learned. Okay, so let us revise just. Some commonly used non-standard units of the length. Some commonly used non-standard units. Non-standard means they are not, like I told you, the hand span. It is non-standard. It is not standard. Why? Because if I measure the length and you measure the length, will it be same? No. So we cannot say exactly what is length of this blackboard using hand span. Suppose it is 20 handstand. My 20 handstand, your it will be 25 or 30 handstand also, okay? So exactly we cannot tell the length of this blackboard, this board, okay? So see, some commonly used non-standard unit of lengths are, right there, handspan or cubit. Cubit means the distance between middle finger to elbow, okay? And footspan also, okay? Footspan, this way. Second, such measures are not accurate because these lengths are dash for different people. These lengths are, as I told you now, these lengths are different for different people. So, right, this was first. Second, right, different. Different for different people. Third, the standard unit of length is, just now I have told you and you have learned in previous classes also, the standard unit of length is meter, and in that only second part is, it is represented by m. In short, it is represented by m, that is meter, okay? Fourth, thus to measure smaller lengths we use dash. As I told you, to measure smaller lengths, we use which unit? Centimeter. And it is denoted by, it is represented by cm. Okay, cm, that is centimeter. Understand? Second, next, if a meter is divided into dash parts, this is very important. See here, if a meter means 1 meter is divided into dash parts, then each part is a dash. See, if there is 1 meter, 1 meter length. Suppose this is 1 meter length, okay? It is there. If this 1 meter length is divided into 100 equal parts, how many equal parts? 100 equal parts, then each part is called 1 centimeter. How centimeter is formed? See, or how much centimeter is smaller? If this is 1 meter and it is divided into 100 equal parts, how many equal parts? 100 equal parts. Then each part is called 1 centimeter. Means this 100 centimeter makes 1 meter. Understand? 100 parts, then each part is called 1 centimeter, okay? Means 100 parts means 1 meter it is. 100 parts means 1 meter and each of 100 part is called 1 centimeter, okay? So here, if a meter is divided into 100 parts, how many parts? 100 equal parts, then each part is called centimeter. So we can conclude that 100 centimeter makes 1 meter. Okay? This 1 meter means actually 100 parts. Each part is centimeter. So 100 centimeter is called 1 meter. Okay? Next. Sixth one. We say dash centimeter is equal to 1 meter. So we say 100 centimeter is equal to 1 meter. Or dash meter is equal to 100 centimeter. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. Understand? Next. To measure distance from one place to another, we use. Now see, this is for longer distances. To measure distance from one place to another, khed to Chiklun, khed to Ratnagiri, khed to Mumbai, which unit we use? Kilometer. Kilometer, okay. If a kilometer is divided into dash part, then each part is a dash. Now see what is conversion of kilometer. You know, kilometer is bigger unit. See, meter, here smaller centimeter, and bigger kilometer. You know, 100 centimeter makes 1 meter. Now, kilometer is related to the meter, okay? So, kilometer is bigger than meter. So, how many meters make 1 kilometer? Centimeter is smaller than meter, and we know that 100 centimeter makes 1 meter. Meter is smaller than kilometer. So, how many meters make 1 meter, a kilometer, you know? 1000 meter is equal to 1 kilometer. These two convergences write in your notebook. 100 centimeter is equal to 1 meter and 1000 meter is equal to 1 kilometer. These two convergences are very important. Understand? So, write in your notebook immediately. Okay? And recite them. Okay? Now, see. If a kilometer is divided into 1000 parts, then each part is a meter. Each part is a meter. That means 1000 meter means 1 kilometer. We say digest meter is equal to 1 kilometer. We say, here I am writing, we say 1000 meter is equal to 1 kilometer. Or 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meters. Okay? Next, 10th one. To measure small lengths, we use a dash dash. To measure small length, we use a dash dash. Scale or meter rod. Meter rod, obviously, it will be big. So, we use scale. Understand? So this was just a revision about the concept of length. Okay, the units of length we have seen: meters, smaller unit centimeter, bigger unit kilometer. 100 centimeter is equal to 1 meter. 1000 meter is equal to 1 kilometer. So now today, what you have to do, you know, you have to perform one activity. What is that? See, you have to measure the various length of the various objects which are available at your home. Okay, so there should be maximum 10 objects whose length you have to measure and write on the page. Write on the page of the notebook. Upside write your name and send me photos today itself. Okay, so thank you for today and have a nice day.